This video shows the making of an Iron Age ring, which was found in a Celtic grave in Switzerland. The model is made from wax and covered in loam. During the firing of the mold, the wax melts and the negative impression of the model is preserved in the loam mold. Here, beeswax and soot are used to make the model of the ring. With black wax, surface defects are much easier to spot. Now the wax is modeled into shape. The lost wax technique allows us to cast bronze objects of virtually any design. Once the model is done, the molding process may begin. To that end, the model is covered with molding loam. First, the core is placed inside the ring. It is responsible for molding the inside surface of the ring, and it is also responsible for cooling down the ring to prevent deforming the delicate wax model. Great care must be taken to ensure that the loam touches every bit of wax surface. Air pockets in the loam layer will produce a surface of inferior quality. The ingate or casting funnel is attached. This way the wax can leave the mold and the liquid metal can be poured into it. The mold is now dressed on the outside, as cracks often start from irregular surfaces. At this stage we call the mold green mold, as it is still damp. Into these green loam molds metal cannot be poured. The molds require firing first. The green molds are left for a little while before they are placed onto the hot furnace rim, the funnels facing the heat. Wax issues from the mold as they are being dried. After drying, the chemically combined water needs to be removed. This is done by firing the molds for a couple of hours at approximately 900 degrees Celsius. This is an extremely important step. At 1150 degrees Celsius, any remaining water is evaporated extremely quickly. If water is trapped beneath molten metal, it may discharge explosively, taking along any hot liquid material in its way. This may cause serious burns to those body parts close to the casting funnel. With this reconstructed furnace, the metal may be heated up to 1150 degrees Celsius. As to whether the furnaces of the Iron Age did look like this is open to discussion. Up to now, no complete furnace has been unearthed. The lost wax, or cire perdue process, is a very old process. The Nahal Mishma hoard from Israel presents the oldest known objects cast with this technique. It is more than 6,000 years old. At that time, arsenical copper, an alloy of copper and arsenic, was widely used. About 5,000 years ago, bronze, an alloy of copper and tin, was adopted by our ancestors. Here you can see the crucible used for melting. Inside, there is molten bronze. Floating on top of the bronze is charcoal, which is good, because it prevents the oxidation of the metal. Before casting, the charcoal has to be removed from the metal. Pulling the crucible from the furnace and casting the metal should be done in one smooth, uninterrupted, sweeping motion, because there is very little time before the metal is too cold for successful casting. Small molds should be left alone for a minute or two before they can be moved. Bronze is hot short and breaks easily when red hot. Once the metal stopped glowing, it can be quenched in water. This produces a finer grain and has positive effects on the mechanical properties of the metal. To retrieve the cast, the mold has to be broken. To bring the ring into its final shape, there are two ways possible: by hammering or by grinding. Of course, these are not mutually exclusive. Here you can see that the ring is roughed on a coarse sandstone. This is followed by finer grindstones, each removing the scratches left by the coarser stone. Needless to say that this is rather laborsome work. Polishing may be achieved by many different means. Here, leather and powdered clay are used. After proper fining, the ring polishes rather quickly. believe it or not. After some 20 hours of roughing, fining and polishing, it is done. The ring is finished. Leave a comment or subscribe if you liked this video. For more information on archaeometallurgy, visit my website archaeometallurgy.de.